beanie from the bedroom here. You could tell I'm drunky. So yeah, I had to redo this. I delayed it. The first video I made with this song, describing the guitar. I don't know what happened to it. It got taken off of YouTube. The second time I uploaded it, my buddy of mine, a professional musician. Now this guy has been playing. He's been on TV since he was 16. He's played in stadiums. He's played in everywhere from New York to California. He's in GIT or that Guitar Institute school where Robin Ford and everyone else was that he knew. He was there as well. So he's been playing his entire life, and he said I was playing that in the wrong key. So, unbeknownst to me, I thought it sounded right. I deleted it. So I did it again. This time I tried not to do it exactly the way I taught myself how to play it the very first time I learned the song when I was a kid. Excuse me. So, yeah, the first time I learned how to play it was like this. And that's the very first time I started using four fingers on the guitar. I think it was 72, 73. I was 12 or 13 years old. I was still playing my nylon acoustic classical guitar. And I've since then, you know, of course, I learned that it was here. And then, when I would play it, I would also play it in this manner. Now, Richie Blackmore showed me, I saw it from him, that he would play it on occasion live with one thumb. Which I guess you gotta be really lazy to play it that way, but maybe he got tired of playing it, you know, every night after night. I don't know. But yeah, there's multiple ways of playing it. So because I've learned it this way and this way, the solo was in this area. However, this song is a key lower, so instead of it being here, it's here. But I played the same solo, even though I was playing the rhythm a step lower. So I've learned by my mistake. And so if you recognize this solo, don't think you're having deja vu, because like I said, the first one that I posted describing the guitar, how I got it, when I got it, I played that, and for some reason that got taken off of YouTube. I uploaded it the second time, and now that one's been deleted because my brother from another said I was playing it in the wrong key, the solo. So you're not losing your mind. However, let me turn that off. Yeah, so I'm just running. I have the DSL 100 watt head up there, and I have the gain set at 10 o'clock, and I have was it Andy Timmons clone? I think it's Demon FX, I forget. I've got that gain set at 10 o'clock, and I stack them two together because that's what you're supposed to do. It gives you more of a punch without really driving the amp, because then it's the amp, the more gain you put on the amp, the more metal it sounds, and I don't like that metal sound. I like that late 70s, early 80s kind of crunch. So, back to the guitar. This is the guitar that I had purchased from guitarcenter.com, their used gear page. It came from Raleigh, North Carolina, and it's in Alder body. It's very heavy. It's got the same weight as my Fender Telecaster. For some reason, I'm used to Alder bodies that are lighter than this, but this has some weight to it. It's hard to tell, but it's a robin eggshell blue, but it's got metal flake in it, and it's really hard to see. This is a really heavy guitar. That's the back plate there. Cover, I always keep just two screws. If they don't have a cutaway where you can get the screwdriver, which you would think they would on a hot Strat like this, a hot rodded Strat, I just leave two screws in it so it's easy to get to. Bridge was leveled. This was tuned to a D when I got it. And the bridge was tilted all the way down like that. Took me all of about 20 minutes to set the whole thing up. These feel like 11-12 gauge strings on here. I've gotten used to the 10s from my Harley Bentons all having 10s, but I'm more comfortable with a 9 to 46 myself, personally. It's got a Floyd Rose on here, and I always say it all the time, it's an original Floyd Rose, but you know, that's only because it says Floyd Rose on it. I don't know whether or not it's a Floyd Rose 1500 series, 1000 series, but I know it's not a Floyd Rose Special because I've had guitars that say Floyd Rose Special on it. I've also had guitars like a ESP that resembled a Floyd Rose and didn't say anything on it, but they looked, they felt, and they sounded just like, you know, they acted just like a Floyd Rose should. I'm not a Floyd Rose snob, like I'm not a guitar snob. I don't care if it comes from the United States, Vietnam, Indonesia, North Korea. You know, to me, if it's a good looking guitar, good quality, it sounds good and plays good, that's all that matters to me. So I've had guys say, yeah, you said it's the original Floyd Rose. Oh, okay. So this may be a Floyd Rose 1000. I know that the difference is a Floyd Rose original is supposed to be the ones made from Germany, and they're like big bucks. And I believe one of my Harley Bentons has that, the black single cut. I'm not sure because I bought it used, but the guy that I got the idea from his YouTube channel, he said on his video that it was the original Floyd Rose, legit, he said. So whether it is or whether it isn't, I don't know, I don't care. So you have your original Floyd Rose made from Germany, you have your 1500 series, then you have your 1000 series, then you have your Floyd Rose Special. Then you have your copycats, like I have on that Ibanez over there. That's it resembles a Floyd Rose. It works like a Floyd Rose, but it's not an original. It doesn't even say Floyd Rose on it. Again, like I said, it doesn't matter to me. You know, so you've got a single ply pickguard on here, volume and tone. Now, when I first got this guitar, the tone was spinning 360 degrees. You would go, you know, from 0 to 10. 0 being the as bassy as you can get, and then 10 being as tony as you can get. And then it's supposed to have a click and a dead spot. Well, if you kept on turning it, it would go back to 0 again, and then, you know, so on and so forth. So I had to bring it back to Guitar Center, and the guy fixed it where it stops at that point, but it doesn't click and bypass the tone knob completely. So I'm waiting for a new knob to come in, which reminds me to give him a call today because it's been over a week, and see what's up with that. Other than that, you've got two Seymour Duncan super distortion humbucking pickups in the neck in the bridge, and you've got a Seymour Duncan, supposed to be a hot Seymour Duncan pickup in the middle. I wish they put a Seymour Duncan fast rail or fast track. I wish they put a humbucking single coil pickup with the split lines in the middle, just to give it that extra more punch, man. Kung Pao chicken. But they didn't. So the way it's set up is five-way. You've got the fifth position humbucker full on. Fourth position, you've got the inside humbucking rail with the inside single coil. The third position, you've got the two outside single coil from the humbucking pickups, the single rails, I should say. Second position is the inner single coil with the inner single rail from the humbucking pickup, and then the first one is neck humbucker full out. You've got 22, looks like medium jumbo or jumbo frets, they feel great, on a ebony fingerboard with clay dot inlays, super nice. It's a maple, super smooth, like a satin neck on here. That's like a wizard neck compared to an Ibanez. You've got your Grover tuners. I put two magnets. I just stuck them on with double stick tape. So, you know, if I want, I could always peel them off and wipe off the stickiness. Just to hold the Allen key and the rod. It's got the spindle rod for the neck adjustment. It's also graphite and enforced, so you don't have to worry about it moving around all too much. That's the back. That's your Charvel plate on there. And I keep two screws on here. If they don't, and I don't know why Charvel doesn't do this, why don't they have that cut notch like other, you know, guitars where you can get the screwdriver in case you have to adjust the tremolo. So when they don't have the cutouts here, I take the other four screws out and I just leave two in, so it's easy to get to. Like I said, I got this sent to me. It was in a tune to D. The tremolo was all the way forward, and these strings feel like 11-12s on it. It took me all about 20 minutes to set it up the way I want it, and it's been a honey ever since. So, yeah. So far, this, and believe it or not, my chips in 59 Greeny Moore Les Paul have been the two that I'm grabbing constantly. Other than that, I would grab my Ace Frehley and I would grab my IYV jazz guitar. You know, it's this is, like I said, this is the kind of curve Fender body that I like on Stratocasters. I'm more comfortable with a Strat than I am a Gibson, but I do enjoy, you know, the Gibsons just as much now as I do the Telecasters, where I never did before. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching, and let me know what you think. So have a good day and a bed tomorrow. Come on.